Hey cute people, I decided today just wanted to play in some makeup. I've been inspired by this one item I hauled the other day, and it's a lipstick from Maybelline. It's called Red Revival. This lipstick to me is so pretty. So I'm going to start off with Skindinavia's Makeup Primer Spray, and one of my new favorites, the Maybelline Fit Me Matte Foundation. With this e.l.f. brush, it just gives me a really airbrushed look, and I really, really like it. And as you can see, I'm just applying it to my face with the brush, and then I'm going to blend it into my skin. And like I mentioned, I really like the results. Now I'm working on my non-existent eyebrows, and I'm using this pencil, one of my favorites. It's flat. And I just like the color. And remember, all the products I'm using, I'll have them listed in the description box below. And if you've been watching my videos for quite some time, you'll know that my eyebrows and I have been through it. Yes. A lot. So I just want to make sure they look good. I always try to get them perfect. I know they're not supposed to be twin sisters, but sometimes mine's like cousins. I don't like that. But I'm going to clean them up a little bit, give them some more shape. And I'm using the LA Colors Concealer. Here I'm using Loreal's Eyeshadow Primer, another product that I like. And I'm just going to blend it in with my finger. I don't want any harsh lines at all. Then I'm using this eyeshadow by NYX. And I'm placing it in my crease. And a little above, I'm using this as my transition color. I just like this color. I think it's just so pretty. And it really warms up the eye. Now I'm using another product that I like. And this is Maybelline's Nude Palette. So I'm going to use this one palette pretty much for my whole eye look. And I'm showing you here how the foundation looks on me when it hits, when it meets with the sun, my face. I just love how it looks. And now I'm just putting on the eyeshadow and I'm pretty much patting it in. I find when you pat your eyeshadow in, it's a little more vibrant as opposed to sweeping it or swiping it. Your eyelid, so I'm just patting it in here, and I like this color. I wear it kind of often. It's really pretty. Now I'm going to use this dusty brown color. I'm going to place it into my crease, and I'm going to also use it to help me blend out the eyeshadow I just placed on my lid. So I won't have any harsh lines. You just use windshield wiper motions. Just go back and forth, back and forth. And then I'm going to use this black color here. I like this black. I'm using it to give my look a little depth. I like it because it's not really a very dark black. So I find it's great for using in the daytime. You just want to have a little depth added to your look. And then I'm using the blending brush here and I'm blending out that black color. And now I'm going to use Wet n Wild liquid eyeliner. I decided not to use black today. Most times I use black, but this is a brown black color. And I find it to be very pretty. And I think it's great for light. You want a natural look for the day. Then I'm using this this mascara here, which is another thing I fight with because I don't have any type of lashes, none whatsoever. And then I'm going to use another favorite of mine. This is Avon's Big Color Eye Pencil. And these things go on so smoothly without much effort. You can't see much here, but I'm using that same gold color underneath my eye. Now, a lot of times, what I'll do, I'll just put on my reader so you won't see those dark circles I have under my eye. But today, I didn't want to wear the glasses all day. So I'm going to cover up those dark spots. And that L'Oreal Secret Studio color corrector does the job. You cannot tell that I have dark circles once I apply this product. And of course, after I do that, I put some concealer on top. And here's the concealer that the product that I'm going to use. And I like this stuff here because it's really creamy. It's thick enough. I still can, blend it without any problem. So once I apply it on my face, I'll blend out any harsh lines. And I also use it as a highlight. I like a little subtle highlight. And then I'm using Ruby Kisses powder to set the concealer I just placed on my face. Because for sure, definitely don't want the concealer under my eyes to be moving around. So I'm just patting it into my face. And then after a while, as you can see here, I'm just sweeping up the excess. Yeah. So we're coming together here. And like I mentioned, I really don't highlight much, but I'm going to highlight today. And I'm what I call makeup lazy. So as you can see, I'm just highlighting my nose. I really don't do my forehead much. Just my nose, because I find that when you do your nose, and maybe even your cupid's bow here, it just gives you a really nice, sleek look, no matter how simple your look is for that day. If you don't highlight anything, do your nose. Contouring is something I don't do often. Again, remember, I'm makeup lazy. But sometimes you want to do a little extra. And I'm just contouring my cheeks. Definitely my forehead. For sure, under my chin. My jawline. And I'm just going back in to blend it out. Because for me, with makeup, I want you to know that I did a little something, but I don't want you to readily be able to see everything that I've done. So I always say I'll blend. And most times I'll blend the makeup right off my face. And here I'm using a favorite brush. And this is Real Techniques blush brush, which I really, really like, and I'm using Max Raven. I'm going back in with blunt. That's what I use to contour my cheeks, blunt. And like I mentioned, for me anyway, if I don't highlight the rest of my face, which I usually don't, I will definitely do something to my nose, because I like the finished result. And I'm using e.l.f. Angled Foundation Brush to do that. Well, my nose anyway. And just to get it to where I really want it, I'm using my fingers to blend some of that contour in. Now I'm using e.l.f. Highlight. And I'm just putting a dot. And you only need a little bit because this stuff has sparkle in it. So if you're going out on a town, you can use an awful lot, but just for a simple everyday, or maybe a special occasion, I only need a little bit. And then I'm using the Soft Focus by Black Radiance to set the rest of my makeup everywhere where I didn't highlight. And I like that stuff too. I gotta do a favorites video. And as you can see, I'm getting ready to use what has inspired me today. And that's this lipstick, Red Revival by Maybelline. And before I paste it on my lips, I use NYX Lip Pencil in hot red, which is another favorite of mine. I like it, I like it. And as you can see, the lipstick goes on like butter, and it's so pretty. So now, so that it give me a really pretty look, I'm using my angled brush, and I'm just cleaning up around my lips just to give it that real pretty polished look. So it'll look nice and neat. Yeah. Now I'm going to use Makeup Forever Set and Mist Spray. That felt good. It did. And this is what my final result looks like. But for whatever reason, I decided to go back into the Maybelline palette. And this is something I usually don't do. And that's highlight the corner of my eye. But I decided, why not? You can't see it much, but it did look really, really good. And as you can see, an old lady is feeling herself. Yes, I am. I had fun, fun, fun. And looking forward to doing more. Yeah. And you can see my light changed, but at least I'm not in the total dark. And I thank you so much for watching. I had a lot of fun creating this look. And I keep saying that I'm going to start wearing lashes, but who knows?